We finally got him, Diamond Camo Rifles in COD World War II. What is up, it's Mikey, and this is my guide for easy diamond camo. If you enjoyed this series, be sure to like the video. First challenge, 100 headshots. Your goal is to get to ambush right here. 100 headshots, it's this unique green camo here. And the first thing is to manage your sensitivity. There's no jetpack flying players, so for the most part, your headshots will take place at ground level. And I'm not gonna tell you what sensitivity to run, but I personally feel having a lower vertical is gonna help you stay on target. This is what I use right here, a 6 and a 5. I'm not telling you to use this. I encourage you to mix and match and see what works best for you. But I personally feel that if you have a lower vertical, that's gonna help you out a bit. Now, back to the actual challenge, 100 headshots. So first, let's talk about these semi-autos. I've already made a separate video on headshots with semi-autos only, link down below to that video. But here I will recap what class and what mode I played. So for the M1 Garand, the M1A1 Carbine, the SVT40, here is the class that I used. And please feel free to mix and match whatever best suits you. This is just what worked best for me. So for the division, I picked Mountain mainly to always remain invisible to the recon and hidden to player controlled streaks. That's pretty good. And really silent movement. If you're a headset user, you definitely want to have that. For the semis, I felt like a reflex sight really helped me out. And remember, by clicking on customize, you could change the reticle to whatever you like. I tended to like crisscross. That was pretty good for me. And grip definitely helped out. I did show this in a separate video, but it truly does help with the recoil, more so on the Garand. But feel free to use whatever you like, but I felt the grip really helped on the Garand. Basic training is scoped while aiming down sights, have less idle sway and move faster. There really isn't much in the way of idle sway in the rifles in the first place, but we really like to just move very fast while aiming down the sights. Helps you catch someone who's moving around. Secondary does not matter, but in hardcore domination, you know, you don't want to throw random grenades. And so that's why I like the S-Mime. You set it and forget it. Usually you can put on your flag around a corner somewhere. Hey, who knows? It may help you get a recon plane or something. So the mode where I got all my headshots was hardcore domination, mainly since all the semis are always one shot kill to the head, no hit marks, very rare. But more important, the somewhat predictable spawns and the added bonus of hearing when someone is capping the flag. And that way, when you're capping it, you can sneak up on them for an easy headshot. So this is why I like Mountain Division. Always off the radar, and you really can't flank, get into position if you're popping up on the minimap. So just nip that problem right in the bud and use Mountain Division, always off radar. Playstyle. The way to play hardcore domination is to flank and hover that sweet spot, that area between the B flag and the enemy spawn. So that's usually their flag. Always sneaking around that zone and never capping their flag. And once you see someone, that's where the basic training scoped. That's where that comes in clutch. It lets you move faster while aiming down the sights, and it makes it just a bit easier to get that headshot. Now, in some maps, you can run into their spawn. Others, you're better off camping around B. You kind of just have to go with your feeling, what feels comfortable for you. But one thing I've learned is never run down the middle out in the open unless you really think you can catch someone. Otherwise, you're just giving up your back and you're probably gonna get shot in the back, and then you get sent to spawn, and then you gotta do your flank all over again. But the other reason why I like Mountain is if you have it maxed out, you get the silent movement, and this allows you to hear footsteps easier. And you notice when I hear someone coming towards me, I stop, sit in a corner, and I let them come through, and notice where I'm pre-aiming. I aim ahead of them to make up for my slow reaction time. Okay, so unless you're some MLG pro with lightning fast reflexes, you always want to aim where you think the enemy's head will be by the time that you can react. Obviously, the map you're playing on, the skill of the other team is a factor, but this is what worked best for me, and you're more than welcome to switch it up. But I highly recommend Mountain just because it allows you to flank without being spotted. Another tip is I recommend staying in the zone. So once you've hit 100 headshots with one rifle, do 100 more on the next rifle, and so on and so forth. So maybe what you could do is make multiple classes, just copy and paste them, and all you do is you change the rifle. Because I really think staying focused on just headshots, that's going to keep your aim on point. So that's semis. What about the full autos? Now you can do the same thing, do the same strategy that you did with the semis, playing hardcore domination, but I needed a break. And for me, the mode war was super easy. The spawns are really predictable. There's no distracting score streaks. And best of all, the deaths do not affect your KD ratio, okay? I will warn you, however, the Neptune map, storming the beach, it's pretty fun. I like it, but it's the hardest to complete headshot challenges on. There's not as many opportunities, at least for rifles. So I would just back out, quit the app. So pay attention when that map gets voted. You're kind of wasting your time. If you're solely trying to get diamond camo ASAP, why play this map? Okay, that's 15 minutes of your time, kind of down the drain there. My setup for war, infantry is great because you get the extra magazines, the additional primary attachment, you get stalk, move significantly faster while aiming down the sights. It's great. I love it. Why would you use anything else? Primary could be whatever you like. And really here, you can mix and match. You know, you can have grip if that rifle demands it. Extended mags is nice. Fewer reloads. But why would you not run high caliber? High caliber is a must here, right, guys? You want that increased headshot damage. And again, you know, you can put on advanced rifling. There's all kinds of choices here. Really, the choice is yours, but high caliber obviously is the must. And the other must is lookout, basic training. Enemy targets appear from further away. Honestly, it kind of glitches. You can see people through smoke. You can see them when they're hiding behind cover. So of the war maps, I'd say breakout is by far the most fun and the easiest to go for headshots. Mostly on that bridge section. And a nice little tip when it comes to retreating from the bridge, what you could do, it's kind of cheesy, hang back, wait till the tank passes, wait till a couple guys walk by, and then run on down there. You don't have to jump, you can just run on down there, and hey, maybe you might get a couple easy headshots. On to the next challenge is the M1916 camo. Get 10 long shot medals with whatever rifle you're working on. So this was super easy. You only need 10 long shots to complete it per rifle. And in a throwback to the BO3 days, hardcore domination was a choice, easy one shots. And be sure to place a mine behind you because you will be hunted. Just camp out the longest part of the map you can find. And yeah, you're gonna get some hate, but hey, it's only for 10 shots per rifle and you should be able to get one or two rifles done per game. Now for the class setup. Division, I suppose it doesn't matter. I guess you could use Mountain, but once you shoot one person, they're gonna know where you're at. So maybe you can use Expeditionary, resupply equipment from killed enemies. What you could do is resupply those S mines. It's a little broken. You probably should not be able to do that, but hey, right now you can. Unlimited S mines and just keep planting them behind you over and over again. Now the attachments truly could be whatever you want, since long shots are really easy to get in hardcore provided you're at a long distance. But I did like the 4x optic. Some weapons you could run grip. FMJ, full metal jacket, is really good. If you notice someone at a distance, they may try to, you know, get revenge on you. They may be creeping behind cover, and so full metal jacket and come in. But really, it truly is up to you. Long shots are super easy in hardcore. And basic training, lookout. I mean, you gotta have lookout there for the gamer tags to pop up easier at a distance. Secondary doesn't matter, but that S mine, you gotta have that, because trust me, they will come looking for you and they will want their revenge. And yeah, you're gonna get some hate messages. And again, I would say copy and paste this same class over and over and over again for every rifle, because you know, getting 10 long shots in one game, one domination game, that's really easy. And so once you're done, just switch on over to your next class and continue to stay in the zone, stay focused, complete that challenge. All right, next up is Snow. Get 50 kills using the infantry division with whatever rifle. That's super easy. I mean, that'll happen on its own. You can play war, you can play hardcore dom, you can play anything you like, it's gonna happen. Same thing goes for Leopard. Get 50 kills with a division other than infantry. Onto Bronze, get 2 rapid kills 5 times with both kills coming from whatever rifle. That's gonna happen on its own. And then we have Copper. Get 5 kills without dying 5 times with all kills coming from your rifle, aka Bloodthirsties, 5 kills. Now, this doesn't have to be 5 kills in a row. It needs to be 5 kills in that life with the rifle. Okay, so feel free to use your S mine. If you need to whip out your pistol, you can do that. But as long as that life, that you're in that life, you must get 5 kills. So, you know, get a pistol kill there, an S mine kill, just get 5 from that rifle in that life. Now for me, this was kind of easy. You could just play war, and what you can do is hover around the objective, whatever it may be. You know, maybe it's a tank. In this example, just hover around it, move around, and the enemies will keep rushing towards that tank because that's an objective. Now, of course, you may get blown up. Maybe you get sniped. Maybe hovering around a tank won't work for you. The other option is just to kind of be a little camper and hang back. But see, in war, you do need campers, because people that are hanging back, they're defending, so you could be a defender. Now for the class setup, that really could be whatever you want. You could use infantry just for the fact you get to have all the multiple attachments. Really, it's just what you think is best. Advanced rifling is really good. Extended mags is going to come in clutch, more so if you're camping around their tank. Whatever the objective is, you don't want to be caught slipping, having to reload, you know, and grip could be good. But again, use whatever you think is best for that rifle. But I think extended mags are probably the big choice, or no matter what rifle you're using. More, again, if you're camping around their objective like a tank, you probably want extended. If you're hanging back, maybe grip, maybe advanced rifling. The other thing that I think is a must, probably lookout. It's just way too good. You know, with a lot of smoke being popped off on war, lookout sort of lets you see through all that, explosions, all sorts of stuff. You gotta have lookout. Easier ID of the gamer tags. Now, if you don't have a good trigger finger, you're not having the best luck, you know, with those semi-autos, then I just went back to hardcore domination and just used the same sneaky, campy type playstyle I use for the headshots. Only this time it was easier since I didn't have to aim for the head. Okay, so again, you're not good with those rifles, just go play hardcore, play hardcore domination and be kind of sneaky and hey, camp it out for those bloodthirsties. But as I said, if you need more help with headshots on the semi-auto rifles, I did make a whole separate video for that, link down below. But if you enjoyed this series and you want it to continue, please leave a like on the video. And that pretty much wraps it up, guys. Let me know in the comments what weapon I should work on next, what tips you want. And in case you missed it, on the left side there, more diamond camo tips, full playlist for you. And on the right, the weekly game chat podcast, out every Friday.